Hello my dear students, so today we will study about chemical coordination. So here the cells or organisms communicate with each other through chemical signals. So there are different types of cell communication. They are autocrine, paracrine, endocrine and pheromones. Now what is this autocrine? So this relating to cell produced substance that has effect on the cell by which it is secreted. So this is called autocrines. Okay. Now next is a paracrines. This relating to a hormone which has effect only in the vicinity of the gland secreting it. So neighboring organs. Okay. Now next is endocrine. Relating to a hormone which has effect on distant cells. So that comes under endocrines. Now pheromones. Here chemicals are capable of acting like hormones outside the body of the secreting individual to impact the behavior of receiving individual. So this comes under pheromones. So these are the types of cell communication. See, in the case of higher animals, they have complex body organization. So here, in the case of complex body organization, here the control and coordination is carried out by the nervous system and the endocrine system. Together, they work for the control and coordination. Endocrine gland secretes their secretion directly into the bloodstream. And that's why they are called ductless gland. These glands secretes chemical messengers, and those messengers are called hormones. Now, general properties of the hormones. Okay, first one, they are produced in response to the specific stimuli. Second, rate of secretion varies from low to very high depending upon the nature and intensity of the stimulus. Third point, they are produced in one organ and show effect on the target organ. Okay, so secretion plays at one side and the effect on the another side. Fourth one, hormone carried through the blood. Fifth, they are bound to specific carrier protein while being transported in the blood. Here, hormones have very high degree of target specificity. Seventh, each hormone acts basically by modifying some aspects of the cellular metabolism. And the last one, the last property of the hormones, here the excessive release or deficiency of hormone may lead to a serious disorders. So these are the general characteristics of the hormones and what are the different types of cell communication we have discussed here. Okay, now we will study about mechanism of hormone action. The hormones act on their target organ or tissue to induce their effects. The target tissue have specific binding site which contains hormone receptors. The hormone receptors are either present on the cell membrane or may be intracellular. The binding of a hormone to its receptor leads to the formation of a hormone receptor complex. Okay, so I've drawn the diagram here, so that also I will explain. Now each receptor is specific to one hormone only, and hence receptors are specific. The formation of hormone receptor complex leads to a certain biochemical changes in the target tissues. Next, now the hormones which interact with membrane bound receptors normally do not enter the target cell but generate secondary messengers such as cyclic एक एएमपी कैल्शियम और कैल्शियम आयन और IP3 आइनोसिटॉल ट्राइफॉस्फेट. ओके सो हियर व्हाट हैपेंड, दिस हार्मोन्स विच इंटरेक्ट विद द मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड रिसेप्टर्स, दे विल नॉट एंटर इनटू द टारगेट सेल बट दे विल जनरेट द सेकेंडरी मैसेंजर्स. सेकेंड मैसेंजर्स फर्दर रेगुलेट्स द सेलुलर मेटाबॉलिज्म. ओके नाउ हियर सर्टेन हार्मोन्स लाइक स्टेरॉइड हार्मोन्स एंड थायरॉक्सिन विच इंटरेक्ट विद द इंट्रासेलुलर रिसेप्टर्स. सो फ्यू स्टेरॉइड हार्मोन्स एंड थायरॉक्सिन. Now here they regulate the gene expression and chromosome functions. The receptors are present inside the nucleus where hormones receptor complex is formed. And the last point is it interact with the genome to evoke the biochemical changes resulting in physiological and developmental functions. Now here with the diagram I will explain this one. These are the points that you have to keep in your mind. Now here this one is the cell membrane. So I have written here ovarian cell membrane. Okay. Now here this one red color. This is the hormone. Here this is the receptor. So receptor which are present on the membrane. See what I written? Hormone which interact with the membrane bound receptors on the membrane. Now here what happened, when the hormone binds with the receptor which is present on this membrane, they will not enter, but they will, what they will do? They will generate the secondary messenger. Generation of secondary messenger will take place. Now because of these secondary messengers, what will happen? They will bring biochemical responses. And these biochemical responses will lead to the physiological responses in the cell. Okay, so this will take place in the nucleus. And here this hormone receptor binding, they will generate the secondary messenger. See, because here I have, same thing I have explained. The hormone which interact with membrane bound receptor normally do not enter the target cell, but generate the secondary messengers. And these messengers will further regulate the biochemical responses and then physiological responses. See, with the example here I have explained. This one is a uterine cell membrane. Here the red color dot, that is that will show the hormone. Example, estrogen hormone is there. So that will enter with the help of the receptor into the cell. Now here this one is a nucleus. Here you can see receptor hormone complex. See, the receptors are present inside the nucleus where hormone receptor complex is formed. So this one inside the nucleus, this receptor hormone complex is formed. Now here this is the genome. It interact with the genome. What? Hormone receptor complex will interact with the genome and that will bring the physiological and developmental functions. See, physiological changes or responses. What is that? Tissue growth and differentiation. So this is the change takes place. Physiological change takes place in the genome because of the receptor hormone complex, and this all is taking place inside the nucleus. So in this way, mechanism of hormone action.